Hi, welcome to White Sands National Monument, home of the largest gypsum dune field in the world. My name is Eugene Ibarra and I'm a ranger here. Today I want to talk about water and wind. At 275 square miles, the gypsum dunes at White Sands National Monument are by far the largest in the world. These majestic dunes are here because of a unique convergence of water and wind. The story begins about 250 million years ago at the end of the Permian period. There was a great landmass called Pangaea. The area I am standing in was at the bottom of a shallow and ever-changing sea. As the sea levels changed, extensive amounts of gypsum was deposited on the seafloor. 70 million years ago, about the time the Rocky Mountains were being formed, the Sacramento and the San Andres Mountains that define the Tularosa Basin lifted out of the ancient seabed to expose the gypsum laid 180 million years before. Gypsum is a unique mineral, soft and water-soluble. During the last ice age, about 20,000 years ago, the Tularosa Basin was a completely different place. Where now we have the Chihuahuan Desert, there was a vast green area, very wet and very cold. In the rainy period of the last ice age, immense amounts of water washed down the mountain sides in great torrents. So intense were these rains that over the years, a great lake formed, covering 1,600 square miles. As the water rushed down the mountains, it dissolved the gypsum and carried it into the Great Lake Otero. For 10,000 years, the process continued. Billions and billions of tons of gypsum moved from the mountains to Lake Otero. In a basin like we have here, there is no outlet for the water to flow to the ocean. Only two things can happen to the water that accumulated in Lake Otero. It could sweep into the water table below or evaporate into the atmosphere above. About 10,000 years ago, the climate began to change in the Tularosa Basin. What was lush and green and wet and cold began to morph into the desert we have today. The waters of Lake Otero began to dry up, evaporate, leaving behind the vast gypsum deposits that the rain had collected in the mountains and deposited in the bottom of Lake Otero in the form of selenite, one of the four crystal forms of gypsum. So the water was responsible for putting the great amount of gypsum into the basin. But the story is only half complete. Without the wind, the dunes could not have formed. Not just wind, but strong wind. In the early spring, just as the winter weather has shifted and split the selenite into platelets, the winds begin. They blow from the southwest to the northeast, across the alkaline areas that remain from Lake Otero, often exceeding 60 miles per hour. The selenite platelets begin to move with the wind, hitting other platelets and the ground. As they bounce along the ground, they break into smaller and smaller pieces. Soon, the pieces are small enough to be sand. They gather together in dunes. When we have winds of 10 miles per hour, the sand begins to creep along the surface of the dunes. At 17 miles per hour, sand becomes airborne and moves quickly across the dunes. When the wind reaches 35 miles per hour, it would move as much sand in a day as the 17 miles per hour wind would move in 3 weeks. The winds move the dunes to the northeast. As the sand moves, it continues to get smaller and smaller until it turns to dust and it is swept into the air. White Sands National Monument is a truly moving miracle. There are 109 national monuments, each with their own unique wonder. Explore and experience America's national treasures.